you mentioned a bad experience, Ezra, that you had, and I'm, you know, we're always big on finding best practices here. Can each of you give me, now not as business owners or managers or executives, but as consumers of either products or services, the brand or two that you have the most loyalty to and why?
I'm pretty loyal to the software systems that I use to run my business. So for example, we've been looking for a new team collaboration service. So something that like can get us off of Skype, essentially, because most of my team, you know, I have a very large virtual team, and we were using Skype for a lot of communications, and it's not archivable, you can't really do file sharing very easily. So I've been looking at HipChat and a couple other ones and looking for team collaboration for, you know, medium-sized teams, and I found a company called Slack, S-L-A-C-K, and what I noticed right away was that, you know, as someone who produces software products myself and sells them to consumers and has people, thousands of people use my software products, one of the sort of pet peeves that I have with software companies is they don't really put a focus on education and training for their software. So I noticed right away that these guys really had together a beautiful interface and really easy step-by-step education on how to use their software. And then I reached out to them. I thought, let me test their customer service. Reached out to them. Boom, right away. They responded back to me on Twitter. I use Twitter a lot to get in touch with companies. I find it really effective. They responded to my email. Now, I've only been using this company for a week, but I'm sold. It's a free service, and I already upsold to the, you know, high-end package. I just love the way that they've communicated with me and the way that they're the way that they had their interface laid out and how easy it was for me to access the education about how to use their platform. And then the second one I would say, and a lot of people give these guys a hard time, but I've really enjoyed my time working with them, which is GoToMeeting, GoToWebinar. That's sort of the backbone of our business in some senses, in that we do a lot of webinar selling, and we use webinars a lot for many different things, for team meetings, for sales, for all kinds of stuff. And I've really found their customer support to be with it and to be on it. And, you know, they're a little buggy sometimes, you know, they've got some problems, but they are the best solution out there. And I've really enjoyed, and I haven't really been doing a lot of communicating with them. My project manager who runs that side of our company talks to them, but he praises them. So
I'm a big fan of obvious value and time to value and quick onboarding. And the company that I'm most fond of lately is Uber, you know. And I was telling a colleague of mine about Uber, and he said, yeah, okay, whatever. I kind of get it. Sounds cool, whatever. And he had to go to a business meeting in Boston. So he's over in Cambridge side, and he finished his business meeting, and his flight out of Boston Logan was about less than 70 minutes from, you know, where he was. They said, John, just take the red line. It's all good. You got plenty of time. You know, just it's all good. So he's crossing the river, and he starts to freak out and panic. So he finds Uber, the app on the App Store. He downloads it. He takes a picture of his credit card. He steps out at the next stop, and a car picks him up within 30 seconds. How does that happen? Right? The perfect value promise delivered instantaneously on a spark of inspiration, right? And that's the competition of every company out here. Every single, that is the customer experience that we all have to deal with now, right? Because every waking moment in a consumer's life, it's a great thing. And then you come into work and you're suddenly in a different decade. And your technology is different, and the norms are different, and it's like, you know, come on, be human first. And if this is a common human experience, then take note, speed up, and get on it, because, you know, this is the table stakes now in 2014. So I'm a big fan of the Uber. Every time I go to a city and it doesn't have the Uber, that makes me sad, but, you know, Uber's awesome.